Hello and welcome to MATLAB Expo Japan. My title for presentation is Deep Insight, a methodology to transform a non-image data to an image for convolution neural network architecture. Title in Japanese is Deep Insight ho niyoru gajo data eno CNN tekiyo. My name is Alok Sharma and my primary affiliation is Riken Japan. My other affiliations are Griffith University, Australia and the University of the South Pacific, Fiji. The coding has been implemented in the MATLAB software. So let us see convolutional neural network or CNN applications. I want to take you to 1980s famous TV series Knight Rider, where a car can drive by itself. It can speed up, make turns, change gear, press brakes, keep a safe distance with other cars or pedestrians, and also can talk with the driver. It took more than 30 years to see this kind of cars on roads, which was dramatized a long ago. Driverless cars are becoming a reality, though challenges are still ahead. It uses AI models to guide vehicles, and CNN is a popular choice due to high performance. So how the driverless car works? It uses sensors, which is connected at different locations, left, right, center. And the data accumulated by sensors are processed via CNN, and then CNN make decision regarding the operation of car. For example, it provides steering command and so on. In a CNN model, the input is an image which can be of airplanes, dog, histopathological images or marijuana plants. These images are processed through various convolution layers which produce a convolved image or an abstract form of image. The output at the fully connected layer can be the class label of the input object. For example, if a dog image is given at the input, the output label will be dog. AI models can efficiently classify objects or cancers. AI models can also guide vehicles like driverless cars. CNN is a popular choice due to high performance, as I said before. However, CNN deals only with images. That means the input should be image. Now let us see Deep Insight project. This is the broader objectives of this project. We want to use AI models like CNN for non-image samples to analyze patient information, to improve detection rate of disease or tumors, to uncover novel phenotypes, to predict drugs using patient information. So input is a data, and data can be, for example, from patient, such as RNA sequence data, methylation data, mutation data, clinical data, drug-related data, or in general, any non-image samples. AI model, which is basically Deep Insight, and the output is accurate tumor detection or discover subset of genes or find drugs using models or to do in general classification. The problem with CNN is it does not work on non-image data, and many patient data and other kinds of data are non-image. So let us see the concept of deep insight. We have many machine learning techniques like support vector machine, random forest, ADA boost, and their performance is still limited on biological data. So the proposal is, can we transform a feature vector to an image? If that is possible, then CNN can be used. So here you can see we have a feature vector of D features, and then we use transform T to make it as a feature matrix. Here let us assume that G1, which is the first feature, is closely related to G3. G1 is also related to G6, and G6 is related to GD. So basically the features which are closely related should come together, and the features which are not closely related to each other should be located far apart. So this kind of transformation we want to find. Now let us see one illustration. So let us say expression data is given, where each point or each feature is representing the gene expression values. And is it possible to convert this expression value into some form of image pattern, where the genes which are closely related come together and genes which are not closely related, they located far apart. So we want to develop some kind of image patterns. So what exactly we want to do is we want to find a transform T which can transform a feature vector X to an image M. Now what are the problems that we can envisage? First is how to define a d-dimensional feature vector to a two-dimensional space. How to find a rectangle encompassing all the data. How to adjust rectangle and data horizontally or vertically. How to find number of rows and columns. How to transform from Cartesian coordinates to pixel frames. So these are the problems that we can see. Now let us see the transformation to 2D space. Now, if you consider samples, let's say x1 is a sample, x2 is a sample, up to xn. So we have n samples, and each sample has d dimensions or d number of features. If you use n samples to do dimensionality reduction, in the lower dimensional space, you will get n samples. However, that's not what we want. Let's say if you take gene wise, G11, G12, G13, G1n, you call as G1. This is a feature vector G1 which has n features. In a similar way, let's say any jth component or jth row we represent as GJ. So if you consider in gene wise, we will have D number of samples. Before we had N number of samples, now we have D number of samples, and each sample has N dimension. So you can see by using gene wise, we have transposed the data. Now we can use some dimensionality reduction techniques like kernel PCA, OT, SNE. Now let us see the process. We have d-dimensional feature vector which is processed by TSNE to get a representation in 2D space. Then convex hull algorithm is used to find the smallest rectangle consisting all the data to discard white noise. Next, the rotation is performed to align axes horizontally and vertically. Please note that these red dots in the Cartesian coordinate system represent the gene or feature locations only, not the gene expression values. Thereafter, Cartesian coordinates are transformed to pixel coordinates, and gene values, which are these values, are mapped onto these locations. Now let us see the allocation of genes or features on pixel locations. If K genes would have the same pixel location, they will be mapped to the location A1, B1, somewhere here. That is overlapping of K genes at a location. On the other hand, if only one gene is pointing to a location, A2, B2, then there will be no overlapping at this location. Once the locations are defined for all the D features using training set, the next step is to map feature values to these locations. If two or more than two features occupy the same location, then their averaged values are used, leading to lossy compression of features. So for low resolution, we will get lossy compression, and for high resolution, we will get lossless compression but large image size. After mapping feature values, you can see the pixel frame, where red cylinder represent feature GM at location A2, B2, and the average K features at location A1, B1. The mapped features depict relative positioning of features on the pixel frame. In a local region, the frame is comprised of spatially coherent pixels. That is, similar information is shared by the pixels near each other. Once images are created from non-image samples, like this one, it is sent to CNN architecture. We have used parallel architecture. However, it is up to the user to select suitable architecture based on one's requirements. We have used four kind of data sets to test our method. These are RNA-seq from gene expression, vowel speech data, text data, and artificial data. We compared our method with machine learning techniques like decision tree, adaptive random forest, and promising results are obtained. Further extensions are also possible, like multiomics data can be analyzed as colored image with three layers, and different kind of data can be normalized and analyzed in a single layer. In this illustration, images produced by Deep Insight method are given. You can see samples from two types of cancers. One is cancer sample 1 and cancer sample 2. Can be noticed straightforwardly. You can see the difference which can be noticed. In a similar way, for text and vowels, the classification becomes easier. So basically, Deep Insight model performs three actions: element arrangement via mapping, feature extraction, and classification via CNN. Some issues with element arrangement step: dimensionality reduction techniques like TSNE and kernel PCA can map data from high dimensional space to 2D space in a non-linear fashion. The samples with similarity map close to each other and with dissimilarity mapped apart. Many linear DRTs map data to a 2D plane. However, mapped samples are highly convoluted, and it becomes very challenging for clustering algorithms to find a reasonable level of groupings. On the other hand, TSNE has the potential to map very high-dimensional data to a 2D plane while keeping the data topology. The TSNE algorithm uses Euclidean distance to compute probabilities. However, in Deep Insight, cosine distance was used. Processing of TSNE can be prolonged. For faster processing, Bernstein algorithm is used to approximate joint distributions instead of the exact distribution. Now let us look at data normalization. The normalization will bring a feature value between 0 and 1, which is required for making an image-like sample. We have two options for normalization. First is min-max normalization, and second is logarithmic normalization. The normalization transforms a value into one of 255 gray shades. This is an important procedure for image transformation. Now let us see the coding aspect of non-image to image transformation. A training data set X with n samples and d features is given, which is sent to cart2pixel function. This gives active pixel locations of features. These pixel locations and a sample X are given to convpixel function, which gives mapping of X to image. All the codings are done in the MATLAB software. Now let us see dataset arrangement. To evaluate the performance of Deep Insight method, we subdivided data into training set, validation set, and test set. Entire training set is used to obtain active pixel locations. Thereafter, non-image samples of training set are converted to image samples. Validation set and test set are also converted to image sets. The hyperparameters of CNN are tuned on training set, and the model's fitness is evaluated on the validation set by employing a Bayesian optimization technique for all the trials. The hyperparameters are selected to minimize the validation error. The test set is never been used in the training or model fitting steps. The test set is used to provide an unbiased evaluation in terms of classification accuracy. These data sets are provided to CNN for evaluation. This is a supervised learning procedure. Let us see very quickly what is supervised learning. If you ask what is this object and what is this object to a 3-year-old kid, he will promptly reply to you that it is an apple and an orange. So, what do we understand from this example? A 3-year-old boy can adapt and react to different objects. We want to teach similar adaptation to a machine to recognize and provide actions. Since we have discussed about supervised learning, it would be good to illustrate unsupervised learning very briefly. If a bag of fruits is given where we are not familiar with fruits, but can we arrange them? We can arrange similar fruits together and dissimilar in different bags. So here we have found 3 bags. This is called clustering. Now let us see some properties of Deep Insight. In this model, we do not need to worry for feature extraction for non-image samples, as required in machine learning techniques. This model enables the use of CNN, which is becoming a promise for images in accuracy for industrial applications. Advantages of CNN becomes an integral part of DeepInsight. That is, the versatility of CNN is extended to non-image domain. Some tips: it is not necessary to use parallel layers as done in DeepInsight. You can convert a non-image sample to image sample by card-to-pixel MATLAB code and conf-pixel MATLAB code. You can also build your own specific DNN or use public nets such as AlexNet, SqueezeNet, GoogleNet, ResNet, which are available from MATLAB. Let us see importance of MATLAB in research. Deep learning packages, statistics, machine learning, parallel computing, GPU computing, and a vast range of toolboxes are available. Multi-threading capabilities and multi-GPU execution environment are available. Advanced graphics support for 2D image, 3D image, and videos are available. Very easy to implement without worrying about language syntax. Fast in concept development, such as lesser time required in coding, which can promote research advancement in a rapid pace. Very easy to debug via MATLAB's editor. Useful in many fields of research, not limited to computer science, engineering, bioinformatics, and power engineering. Some drawbacks: it is expensive. Pay for every toolbox. However, institutional licenses are available, having all toolboxes. Restricted use of license. Example, subject to geographical location. Now let us see possible industrial applications of DeepInsight model. It can be used in genome data analysis and research. It can be used in brain-computer interface. It can also be used in proteome data analysis, for example, protein-peptide interactions, DNA binding proteins, and so on. It can be useful for data mining and knowledge discovery. It can also be useful for healthcare, personalized medicine, and drug discovery. And of course, for data visualization and business and finance. Some researchers recently applied DeepInsight. For example, Buterevic introduced an approach inspired by DeepInsight. They applied their approach to gene expression data derived from blood samples of patients with bacterial or viral infections and showed promising results. Similarly, Canva implemented it using sparse data and showed that on Minst database with more than 70,000 samples, DeepInsight shown superior performance than state-of-the-art machine learning method. Paper and tools of DeepInsight method are available. Please see paper from the given link. The DeepInsight package written in MATLAB is available from the given links. I have given some notes about TSNE in case you may wish to check about it. However, not covering in this presentation. Thank you very much for being with me. Arigato gozaimasu.